Okay, we're firing away.
So everyone, this is PJ. As introduced, I'm Sonia, and I'm PJ's support worker, carer, but first and foremost, his friend. Would you say I'm your friend?
No, not really.
No, not really. So we've started off really well here, haven't we?
No, not really.
He's a joker too, by the way. He loves to play a joke.
What joke?
No jokes just now. This is a serious time.
Why?
You get a laugh. Now, PJ also has another support worker called Corinne. She's a lovely lady that you've known for how long?
6 years.
6 years. Do you want to say a little bit about Corinne, how she helps you?
She's a very good friend. I know her for many years now. And she's a good friend.
Yeah. She does a lot for you. There's nothing she wouldn't do for PJ. And the same goes for me, of course. All right. Now, PJ has a few messages first before we get into the story about bullying. And one of them is...
Don't be a bully, be a star.
Did everyone get that?
Yes.
Be a star. Nothing better. There's another one that you like to say, and that's you don't like bullying because?
Because it's not right to be a bully.
Yep. And you don't want them to?
To be a bully.
Yeah. Got that?
Yes.
PJ's goal for a very long time has been to talk to students just such as yourselves, and he's done it. This is his first talk. So I think we should clap. Okay. He's here to also send a message to each and every one of you. And I'll say it for you. I don't want any of you to ever have to go through what I've been through in life. Okay. With a show of hands, has anyone in here been bullied or know of anyone that has? Wow.
That's a lot of hands.
That's a lot of hands. How do you feel about that?
Pretty good about it.
Pretty good that you're here to talk about it. It gives you a reason. But it's not good there's so many hands. You can put them down here. Thanks for doing I'm going to pass around some photos first because I want you to get to know PJ from the age of zero, so baby, through to when the accident actually happened, because PJ wasn't born like this. So if you could all, I'll start from you. You could just have a look and a quick read and just pass along and I'll continue to talk. You probably don't want me talking, but... I've known PJ personally for a year and a half, so not very long. And he would have to be the most caring individual I've ever met.
Why?
He's got a positive outlook.
Why?
You've got a positive outlook on life.
Why?
You've taught me not to look at what is wrong in life, but what is right, and the wrong usually fixes itself.
Why?
PJ, quiet, this is my time. In my eyes, he's cheeky, would you agree?
Yes.
Funny?
Yes.
And loves to play games on you when you least expect it?
Yes.
PJ's smile lights up a room, even a gym. And he loves to laugh and make others laugh, would you agree with that?
Yes.
PJ loves life, loves people, loves his friends, and lives life to the fullest. Good thing. As you can see by the photos that have been passed around, PJ was a happy little boy with blonde hair and massive big blue eyes. He loved to play with his older brother Robert and his sister Amanda. PJ had tons of energy and a love for life. He loved to play jokes on the siblings, his brother and sister, and on his dad and mum. PJ's home is and has always been in Hampton Park. So he's a local. Now we're going to get to the actual incident, the accident. And this is very serious, so I need you to be serious here, okay?
What?
PJ, promise me.
I promise.
Thank you. No. I don't believe you, but anyway. At the age of 5, PJ was at his primary school, just like you guys, when 2 teenage boys were being very nasty to PJ and there were words exchanged between them. Now, I'm now saying this, what happened to PJ. But this is from PJ's mouth, but I'm saying the words. These 2 boys grabbed my body, lifted me up and held me by my legs. Then they shoved me headfirst into a toilet. Yep. And left me there with my legs hanging out. Not good, huh? My best friend Matthew, age 6, pulled me from the toilet and he saved my life. Matthew told my sister Amanda, who was age 8 at the time, that he found out one of the teenagers' names. But PJ can't remember if these teenagers were ever caught. So we really don't know what happened. These are now my words, and in my opinion, these 2 teenagers were cowards, picking on someone a lot younger and smaller than them. Now, these are now PJ's words. The next night when I was in bed, my dad and mum heard me coughing, and it sounded strange to them. They both came into my bedroom, picked me up and took me into their bedroom and laid me out on their bed. My body started to have a fit, a seizure, where it convulsed up and down and in the air, and I landed on the floor. My parents picked me up and drove me to Dandenong Hospital. He was only there for a short time and was airlifted to the Royal Children's Hospital. You've heard of that one?
Yes.
Big hospital in Parkville, isn't it? Mm. Yeah, near the city there.
Mm, near the zoo.
Near the zoo. But you weren't in the zoo.
Yes, I did.
The best doctor in the world operated on me for 16 hours. Now, can you imagine what 16 hours is in your day? You sleep for 8 hours off, and that makes 24. So when you're bright-eyed and bushy-tailed during the day, that's your 16 hours. They were operating on PJ's head for that amount of time. That's a long time. What I'd like to do is show photos of PJ. And there's going to be a bit of a printout on the back. So when you look at the picture, turn it over and have a look at the back. And that's what happened to PJ's brain with this toilet incident. So I'll start with you again. Thank you. So I'll keep talking. With these photos, I just wanted to know, PJ, how you're feeling at this very moment talking about your accident.
Pretty good.
Why are you good?
It is out of my chest.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It helps you to talk about it and hear about it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? And what's your outlook on life?
Pretty good.
He's a good man, isn't he?
Yes. Yes.
These are PJ's words. I was in a coma, so unconscious in hospital, for 6 months. That's a half a year. It's a long time. My father, Peter, visited me every day of that 6 months I was in a coma. and my mother Jean only miss visiting me for 3 days of the 6 months. That's a long way to travel to see me and go home again. Hampton Park to Parkville and back to Hampton Park. Every single day for 6 months and also having to work full time. You agree?
Yes.
That would be hard. While in a coma, I had around 30 operations. 30. And received 30 staples in his head. These operations were due to me having seizures while I was in a coma. When I awoke from the coma, I had all my family and friends around my bed. The first thing I did was to laugh and to say the words Dad and Mum. After coming out of the coma, I was tube-fed for 4 months, meaning no food or drink by mouth, for 4 months. My very first meal, guess what it was? McDonald's. And guess what he had? What did you have?
Chips and ice cream sundae.
Chips and an ice cream sundae. And you said, wow, that was a great meal. 3 to 5 days per week, Mum would take me for therapy. And this lasted for 4 years. I had to relearn all the basics of living again. I had to learn how to talk again. I had to learn how to eat, how to drink, how to use spoons, knives and forks, to learning how to shower, go to the toilet, everything that all of us do without thinking. I also had physio, which taught me how to try and walk and build my muscles up to give me some sort of strength. I was very sick from the age of 5 through to age 11, due to not being able to control the need to go to the toilet. I was in nappies for many years. So at 5 years of age when the accident happened, he was well out of nappies. Then he had to go back to them again. So I want to show you now another photo of PJ aged 10 and 8. At the age of 11, I went to hospital again for a major operation due to epilepsy and seizures. I was very sick, but I had wonderful doctors, nurses, physiotherapist, Dad, Mum, Rob and Amanda around me. PJ, what were your nicknames for your brother?
I don't want to talk about it.
Bulfa?
Bulfa. And whatever.
Kermit?
Yeah.
How could you forget that? Why Kermit the frog?
He used to talk like that.
Oh, in that high pitched voice. Yeah. Everyone know Kermit?
Yes.
Yeah. That's a funny voice to have, isn't it? So there's another photo I'll show you. This is when he went back to hospital because of the seizures that he was having. So he's back there again, very, very sick. Not expected to live. So a second time around, the doctors thought, no, he's not going to make it. He'll pass away. But he didn't. He's a strong man. At the age of 23, PJ was on the front page of your local newspaper, News. Unfortunately, it wasn't a good news story, but a cowardly act that took place in his own home in October 2010, 7 years ago, nearly. So at 10:30 in the morning on a Friday, PJ was asleep in his bedroom, and at the time he was home alone. Two people broke into his home, entered his bedroom and deliberately pushed over his wheelchair so he could not get out of bed and protect his safe from being stolen. The safe contained very personal and precious gifts and good luck charms from classmates and friends after various operations PJ had. PJ used his left arm, because he does have some mobility, he can use the left arm. So he used his left arm to shuffle across the floor on his side to the front of the house to see what else had happened. He called his dad Peter, who was at work at the time. Hasn't had much luck, has he?
No.
PJ was traumatised after this cowardly act, and what he had been through further eroded, which made his health worse, basically. PJ's dad was quoted in the news article saying, "We've been in this home for 25 years and nothing like this has happened. I was very surprised and frightened for PJ. He's all out of the box." So, this is the news article. You're a lucky one being first, aren't you? So PJ has a wonderful father, Peter, who also has a terrific sense of humour, and I kind of know where this one gets it from. Peter is PJ's sole carer and calls his son Tush. Why does he call you Tush?
I don't want to talk about
it. Oh, okay. Maybe for another time. PJ's dog...
Another generation.
Another generation, okay. PJ's dog, Coke, is a Doberman. Do you know what a Doberman is?
Yes. Yeah.
Aren't they big?
Yeah.
Big dogs. He's 15-year-old this year, isn't he, Coke?
Yeah.
And he's got severe arthritis in his back legs. You know what arthritis is?
No.
Oh, it's aching bones where you can hardly walk. I've got it myself in my knees. It's not pleasant.
When your bones stiff up.
They stiffen up, yes.
And it feels like ice.
Youch.
Mm-hmm.
Don't remind me.
Mm. I already know that. In front of her.
Oh, thanks. Her's the cat's mother, thank you. Yeah, she is.
Yeah, no.
Oh, you're nice.
Yeah, so, no, I'm proud of it.
Coke is going to be featured in one of the photos that you see, asleep on PJ's dad's bed. So, there's... just a couple of more photos to go. But this is PJ later in life, 26, and a little bit older. So PJ works out at a local gym. He lifts weights and he walks on the treadmill. This is to promote muscle strength in order for PJ to remain independent. For example, getting in and out of bed, being able to go to the toilet on his own. It's very important to PJ to be able to do those things on his own. His father, Peter, assists PJ with showering, and PJ has his own transport van that we arrived in today that fits his wheelchair in, and he uses it regularly. PJ also catches public transport on his own, and his independence is very important to him, isn't it?
No.
Oh, Peter. So I'll show you the pictures of PJ on the treadmill. So that's in there. Now make this easy for me, okay?
Why?
Now PJ, what do you want for the world? Do you want it to stay the same?
No.
What do you want for it?
Make it better.
You want to make it better?
Mm-hmm.
I think all of us can do our part to make a better world, can't we?
Yeah.
And what's your message for children, you know, that are going to school together and playing together, etc.? What's your message to them? Kind and gentle.
Kind and gentle and be a better person.
Be a better person. And PJ often says it's important to have respect for each other.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Yeah, good. He loves to make people laugh. Well, we've seen that today, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
And he loves them being happy, don't you? Oh. And PJ would love to travel someday, so that's another goal that he has, and I'm sure he's going to meet that goal. Now, I would like to speak for myself now about PJ. So this is me. With everything PJ has been through in his life, he is a man that keeps fighting. He never gives up and has not let the cowards that have robbed him of so much change the way he is. PJ is one of the greatest men I have ever met in my life, and he has shown me that anyone can do anything in life, and there is no such word as can't. You're all capable of so many things. PJ sees the good in everyone, but can also see bad in people, but will quietly voice this to his friends and family if he gets a bad feeling. We all get that sometimes when we meet someone. Even PJ's doctors believed he wouldn't survive operations, but up comes PJ, stronger and funnier than ever, to prove them all wrong. I can't thank PJ enough for accepting me as his carer and friend. Thank you. He has changed my life for the better, and I hope in some way he can change your lives for the better as well. PJ, although a victim of crime, does not live his life as a victim. To me, PJ is a hero. Thank you. He's still going. I'm crying. And he's making fun of me. Would you like to thank the teachers, the principal, vice principal, and the students for today?
Thank you very much.
Yeah, to everybody?
Yep.
Okay. Do you have any last words for anybody here today?
Don't be a bully.
Be a star.
Mm-hmm.
And?
Want to sign my book? Anyone?
Yeah? Mm-hmm. That'd be fantastic. If you want to all sign it, just write a little something. Maybe sign your name underneath if you've got some time. You'll need a pen, PJ.
I got one.
Okay. So thank you, everybody. Do anyone have any questions?
No.
No? You're a quiet bunch. I would prefer not to mention, yeah. It's a good question, but it's not the right thing to do. Anyone else? Yeah.
Well, apparently the name of one of them that they found out about, they don't know what happened after that. Anyone else? Yes.
Did you talk to the principal about the incident?
No.
No. It was sort of kept a bit quiet because we didn't know anything was wrong until the following night when he started coughing funny.
I had wet hair and green hair.
Green hair?
When I was in the toilet.
Oh. Anyone else?
How old
are you, PJ?
29.
29? And how old are you going to be in June?
30.
Does he look 30?
No.
How old does he look?
17.
What?
24. 29. 23. 20.
Wow. You're going to give him a big hit.
13 years.
On and off for 13 years?
Yeah.
thank you for coming to our school and explaining how bad bullying is, and hope our school can make a better decision and not be bullied.
And a better place.
Yeah, and hope our school can make this whole world a better place.
Thank you.
Fantastic, thank you.
Thank you for sharing your story with us about what happened. And hopefully everyone else feels will want to end something like that again.
Be better people, yeah. Yeah. That's wonderful, thank you.
Thank you.
Now, PJ would like to greet you with like a little handshake, so give him the handshake. That's it, knuckles to knuckles. That's the way. Thanks very much.
Can everyone give PJ a clap?